Hey guys, it's Kay, I hope you're all well. Now in today's video, I'm going to be looking at this Android TV box from a company called Digibox. They've seen my channel on YouTube and they generously decided to send me this unit for review. So with this review, I'm not going to be holding back. If there's anything I like, I'm going to tell you, and if there's anything I don't like, I'm definitely going to tell you. As you can see, it does come with the standard specs of any Android TV box out there. You've got Android 12, Wi-Fi 6, 6K HDI support, and notably 4GB of RAM and 64GB of storage. So without further ado, let's take a look inside the box, and the first thing we see is, of course, the Digibox itself. And it's your usual little black box affair. We get a nice little Digibox branding in silver on top, LCD display up front, which is a tad smaller than I'm used to, but as long as all the information's there. To the side it's clear, and on the other side we've got our main connectivity ports, we've got an SD card reader and 4 USB ports, where you can connect extra storage or peripherals. Now on the bottom we've got some rubber feet and some venting holes. To the back we've got our fold out aerials, which again is a pretty standard design in these TV boxes. Ports wise on the back we've got our IR in, AV in, Ethernet connection, HDMI in, audio out and power in. Overall it's a pretty sturdy design, even if it is just made out of plastic. I suppose it keeps the weight and cost down. So what else is in the box? Let's take a look. First up it's our HDMI cable. Next we've got our power brick, it's our usual interface, and it's 5 volts at 2 amps. We've got a compact and bijou remote control. Nevertheless, we've got all the functions we need on it. Power, volume, channels, settings, D-pad, OK button. We've also got a microphone for an AI assistant, and of course the home button. Batteries wise, we're rocking 2 AAAs, which is a standard these days. And last up, we get a quick start guide, which is short and to the point. But then again, these TV boxes are really made foolproof. You can't really go wrong, it's just plug and play. So guys, this is all you get in the box. Next, we're going to power up the Digibox and have a look around the home screen. And the first thing we're presented with is a screen to pair the remote with the Digibox. And it is quite straightforward, just hold the two buttons shown simultaneously and it should pair automatically. You'll get the following screen pop up, just click on next, and you'll get the language selection screen. So I'm going to choose American English, and then just click on next, and you should get the network selection screen. So here you can plug in an Ethernet cable or select your Wi-Fi network and put in your password. So I've skipped forward to connecting to my network now. And that's it guys, we're on the home screen, and it's a fairly familiar affair with all these TV boxes. To one side you've got your date and time and a little Digibox thumbnail. Top right we've got some buttons, we've got a contact us, which is a quick way of contacting the help desk if you've got any issues. Next to that we've got an internet speed check, so if you are experiencing any lagginess you can check the internet speed the box is connected at. And next to that we've got a quick help guide. Now I do think this is a pretty useful idea. It's basically a self-help guide which is built into the Digibox. And you just click on the issues that are affecting you and it will guide you through to a solution. Next we've got a self-starting management option, which lets you set up apps that start up on boot up. Next one along is set quick launch. Now this is a cool little feature. It lets you map the red and yellow button to apps so you can quickly launch them by just pressing those buttons. Next one along is your Bluetooth setup, and from here you can add your headphones, your speakers, and literally any other Bluetooth device. Next one across is your memory cleaner, so again if you are experiencing any issues with lagginess, you want to clean out those apps that are not working in the background, and indeed any junk files. And next we've got our Wi-Fi settings, and of course you've guessed it, you can connect your Wi-Fi networks here. Next across we get an option to download an app, which is the mobile remote, and it's a smart app that lets you operate the Digibox from your cell phone. Definitely a handy feature if you lose the remote. And lastly we've got the more settings icon, where we can change our wallpaper, we can set it to auto or manually change it, and it can be set to rotate at regular intervals. We've got a settings icon, and this will take you to your regular Android settings. And let's just quickly scroll down to device preferences and all the way down to about, and you can see here that we've got Android TV OS version 12, and of course it is a custom Digibox version. Now there is this handy adjust the screen app, which you can use to adjust the picture on your screen. You also get the option to mirror cast the screen onto a remote device. Just follow the on-screen instructions. We also get the option to change our language on screen, change the system time, and of course uninstall any apps you've got installed. And I don't have any installed at the moment, so there's nothing here. We can reset the TV box to factory defaults, but I don't want to do that. We've also got the option to update the system. And finally, we've got the shortcut to the file manager. Okay, back to the home screen, and on the bottom part of the screen, we've got our access to our favorite apps. And you can add an app by simply clicking on an empty thumbnail. Scrolling down from here gives you even more room to store your favorite apps. And talking of apps, let's take a quick look at the apps folder. And here we can see we've got some pre-installed apps. We've got the actual device's app store, the Google Play Store, Netflix and YouTube, to name a few. So here's some of the apps you can download from the Digiboxes app store. Just click on the app you're interested in, it'll give you a bit of information and the relevant link. Okay, back on the home screen, you can see I've populated some of my favourite apps from the app store. And the first thing I'm going to show you is the streaming capabilities of the Digibox. And straight away on YouTube, you can see it goes straight into the video with no stuttering or lagging. So we're definitely off to a good start. The picture's sharp and clear. And if we scroll across and take a quick look at the resolution, you can see we're currently streaming at 1440p, which is the resolution of my monitor. And the box is handling this with no issues at all. And if we want to skim through a video at this resolution, there's no issues also. The video starts streaming straight away. Let's take a quick look at the internet browsing capabilities of the box. So straight into Chrome and search for news. And no preferences here, I'm going to click the first link. Now to make browsing more easier, just click on the mouse toggle button on your remote and you'll get the little mouse hand appear on the screen and you can browse and click on links as you would on your computer. Now the Digibox comes with three great features. You've got live TV, video on demand and playback TV. So first let's take a look at live TV. And it jumps straight into a live stream. And the first thing I can say is that the quality looks very good, sharp and stutter free. If you press OK on the remote, you get some information about the current program you're watching. Press left on the D-pad and you get an EPG guide. And you can scroll through all the categories and the countries. And there's a fair few, as you can see. There's also a search option you can use to find exactly what you're looking for. You can also add channels to your favorites for quick access to your favorite channels. Definitely a handy option as there is so much choice here. Okay, next let's move on to video on demand. And again, this setup is very much like most TV boxes out there. Along the top, we've got favorites, history, and a help section. And just below that, we've got categories like recommend, movies, series, anime, and finally information. To the left, we've got search. And it's just like any other search functions. It brings up a keyboard, you type in your search, and voila. Below the search, we've got our major categories. New series, new animes, popular movies, popular series, popular animations, and top rated movies. And not forgetting top rated series. Just select what you're interested in, click on the icon, and you get two options to play or add to your favorites for later. And if it is a TV series, you get the option to select the episode you want to watch. So lastly, we've got our backup app. This is a selection of sports channels where the content's been recorded, so previous events that you might have missed, you can watch at your leisure. So all in all guys, a pretty impressive package here from Digibox. I wasn't expecting anything, but I was pleasantly surprised at what you're getting here. At the end of the day, it's another option for us consumers out there, and competition keeps the marketplace fresh and up to date. Now once you're done with the Digibox, shutting down is simple, just press on the power button and you get the following options. You can power down, put the device to sleep, just in case you want to pop out and make a cup of tea and you don't want to go through the whole process of powering up again. And lastly, you've got the reboot option. This is handy if you're experiencing any issues. Just reboot and hopefully they'll be fixed. Anyway guys, if you found this video helpful, please do give us a like and consider subscribing for more great videos coming soon.